Well, experts say it's the biggest and most advanced cyber weapon ever discovered. It's called the flame virus. Joining us for more on this, Morgan Wright, a cyber terrorism analyst. Morgan, sometimes these things have fingerprints. Whose fingerprints are on this?
Well, I don't have any intimate knowledge. I'd love to say it's ours, because I'll tell you what, this is one way to take down a regime that has ill intent. There's nothing good that can come out of what Iran's doing. So if it's us, I say, hey, good job, guys.
Well, it's being described as being 20 times more code than Stuxnet. That was the virus that took down, reportedly took down some of the nuclear facilities in Iran. I don't know a lot about 20 times more code. To you, someone who's an expert on cyber terrorism, how much more complicated does that make this virus? How much more effective?
It makes it tremendously effective. In fact, some of the reports coming out today are about, we're hearing about special forces parachuting into North Korea to do reconnaissance. Flame was designed to do exactly the same thing, but in a but on a network. I mean, we're mapping out vulnerabilities, we're mapping out data systems, we're understanding where they store information, how they get, use, and move information. It's all designed to target their ability to make decisions, to be able to enable nuclear or uranium enrichment. It's designed to take down their ability to produce these weapons. And I'll tell you what, it's obviously very effective. It kind of the play, which came first, the chicken or the egg, which came first, the virus or the worm. It sounds like in this instance, this has been out there for a while collecting the information so that Stuxnet could be delivered right on target, just like a precision munition.
Nice to have you,
Absolutely.
Morgan. As we learn more about this, we'll have you back and look forward to talking to you again. Thank you.
You bet. Thanks again. Have a good day.